Hansen works at Taos Center for Natural Healing. She is a kinesiology chiropractor specializing in emotional balancing. And she's here to help us learn how we can be true to our finest nature. So here is Dr. Margaret Hansen, and it's entitled, It's All in Your Head.
But I'm going to take this up there with me. Oh, I'll get you the camera. Remember that old diagnosis? Ah, it's all in your head. Oh, thank you. It's used when there's no apparent physical reason for your pain and suffering. Sometimes it's a sign that you've reached your practitioner's knowledge limit. And yet, sometimes it's true. The cause of your pain and suffering is in your head, if by being in your head, it's really in your subconscious and unavailable for your conscious mind to figure out. Sometimes, release from pain and suffering is also in your head. A destructive belief gone in a transcendent moment or a spiritual epiphany, or perhaps with planned intention. Healthy beliefs create the healthy template for your body and your life. By contrast, if you've learned that you're unlovable, a victim of the desires and whims of those around you, or responsible for the feelings of everybody else, then your subconscious will manifest a body and a life based on those misshapen beliefs. You may literally have pain in your head or in your back, or your heart, or your gut, on your skin, in your actions and emotions. A misguided subconscious belief can cause you physical pain and ruin an otherwise beautiful life. That's why we balance. We want to rewire your subconscious, unplug fears and misperceptions. In 30 years of emotional balancing, using the paradigm of educational kinesiology, I can tell you two truths. Muscle testing is key to revealing the subconscious, and a dysfunctional subconscious belief can be collapsed and replaced with a restorative one. Here's how I think that works. To begin, we ask your body. Your body stores your emotional history, and it will tell, if we ask the right questions. And our muscle testing key is the key to open your beliefs, what you've come to believe. So let's muscle test. You put an arm straight out in front of you. Maybe Alana will show us. And then I'm going to push. You hold strong. You feel that? Then I want you to run your hand up the front of your body, and we test. Now run it down, and we test. You see, it's not the same. Thank you. And that's actually a pre-check. We want your body to be strong when it means strong. We want it to be weak when it means weak, because those are the two things we have to deal with. So, your confidence builds as you become a participant in your own search for truth. And by confidence, I want you to feel that your body is truly revealing itself. This is an art. This is not lab science with written test results. We are the relationship we're creating. Two seekers for your optimal health. And now, let's balance. I'll guide you in making statements, first person, present tense statements about yourself, because your subconscious really only lives in the present tense. Statements like, I am, who I want to be in my life, and then we'll check it. Strong, not strong. I accept the truth of what's happened to me. I accept the truth of what's happened to my family, my culture. My heart is strength and love. This way we communicate with your subconscious. If your muscle stays strong, it means you believe that statement. And if your muscle is weak, it means it's not true for you. In this way, we reveal what you've come to believe and whether or not it's good for you. Possibly, your muscle holds strong for some irrational, unwanted statement, like, I am responsible for everything and everybody in the world. It's not very uncommon either. Everyone else's needs are more important than my own. Or like, early balances of my own, I doubt my every feeling, and then there was I shouldn't have to work for a living, and you can imagine where that got me. These beliefs are irrational, impossible, but also downright dangerous. So let's help your body release that old belief and incorporate its healthy replacement. But before we do, let's gather a little perspective. Back in the 1980s, I'm sitting in a crowded classroom in an old wooden desk in Palmer Chiropractic College hearing about applied kinesiology, George Goodhart's life work where muscle testing flings open a door to a whole new way to interact with a patient. It's hard to explain the importance of muscle testing to innovative practitioners at that time, sort of like development of the PET scan, positron emission tomography, to scan your brain, or the cell phone. It was a new paradigm in communicating with the body. And in another corner of research, brain gyms are born. Hand-eye gymnastics, cross-crawl, repatterning, intentional movements that seem to reorganize the brain between left and right, thought and intuition, top and bottom, centering you between new brain and ancient brain, and front to back, so you can focus and yet be aware of yourself in the world. Integrating movements that refine your neural pathways, enhance learning and performance, like improving bus service to all of the neighborhoods of the brain. And then, brain gym creator Paul Dennison and Gail Dennison take the concept of re-educating your brain, and they expand it to re-educating your body. And so they add meridian points. To their basket of brain gyms, they add some other things, but meridian points, so that these tools allow us to step into the manifested world of your belief and offer change. And let's think for a clinical minute. What great tools these are. You can't damage the subject by using them. And in our context, we can ask a thing, and we can ask its opposite. I love myself, I hate myself. And who's to keep you from believing two equal and opposite things, particularly in our culture? And here's another one. You can believe the thing, you can also think you don't believe the thing. If that's playing in your background, doesn't that create anxiety and discontent? And now, 30 years later, there's been a lot of detective work using these tools in my balance room. And do you know that to a person, we want our hearts to prevail? Even the worst behaved seem to want this. We want our hearts to prevail, but guess what? We think too much. We're too wounded, rebuked, angry. We want to behave or feel better, but can't until our protective, reactive, wounded belief is replaced with something restorative. Something like, I freely am my true and beautiful self in the world. How about that? I give the world and everyone full responsibility for their own needs and outcomes. And I take full responsibility for my emotional and spiritual desires. My heart is strength and love. So imagine what kind of goal we might find for you. Let's construct the words of your goal. Let's ask your body's permission to balance. And then choose from the basket of brain gyms for the best from the basket. Maybe you choose brain gyms. It's a very common choice because it creates space between your thoughts. Or perhaps meridian tapping, where we allow a meridian to let go of an old concept. We open chakras, repattern neural networks, and then here you are. With relief on your face, muscles relax, capillaries flow, meridians are energized differently. Your body has learned something new. So let's recheck. Those dysfunctional, irrational beliefs that you made just a few minutes ago that you were strong to, they're weak. And when you repeat them, they feel foreign now. And then, drum roll, the words for your balance. Feel it be strong? Yes. Your subconscious has a new template. You have no experience with it yet, but there's a new operating system ready to work for you. So let's write the words of your goal so your conscious mind can catch up to what your body already knows now, and over the next few weeks, it can catch up. Then take it out for a spin. There are rare exceptions when a person is unable to sustain a balance. Usually it's because of religious or relationship influences that do not allow this new freedom or self-actualization. And I don't know if your balance gives your orbital frontal cortex a greater ability to appreciate the consequences of your actions, like the textbooks say, or whether your dorsolateral prefrontal cortex has more flexibility to prioritize your behavior and adapt to change. Because I don't have that PET scanner at my office yet. But here's what I see beyond the changes in your muscle tests. You are more aware of how things came to be. Your hypervigilance relaxes. You are stronger in beliefs that allow you to wield your true self and your true feelings in the world. And then the world changes. And here's a final thought. The concept of balancing the body got expanded to balancing the brain got expanded to balancing the body. Shall we expand the concept of balancing our individual selves to balancing ourselves in community? Why not? Either way, your subconscious belief aligns with your heart, your soul's purpose to create a healthy body and healthy world. And isn't that what we want in your head?